In this video, we're going to start the KutaSoftware Infinite Geometry free worksheet, Similar Right Triangles. We're instructed to find the missing length indicated and then leave our answer in simplest radical form. Now, before we jump into number one, let's quickly go over a theorem for similar right triangles. So, ignoring these measurements in number one, you can see we have a right triangle. An altitude is a segment that goes from the vertex to the opposite side, and it's perpendicular to that side. So this line is an altitude. And there's a theorem that says that if you have a right triangle and you draw the altitude that stems or comes out of that right angle, then the two smaller triangles that are formed by that altitude are similar. And not only that, but they're also similar to that original right triangle. So knowing that, let's look at number one. In number one, our altitude is said to have a length of x. Notice that our right angle of one triangle is here and our other right angle is here. However, this triangle is not in the same position. It is rotated. So this side, that is the altitude, or this leg of the triangle, lines up with this leg. And you can see the shorter leg of that triangle lines up with the altitude. So when we're writing our proportions, since they're similar, in order to find what x is, we can say that x within this first small triangle over that side length of 36 is equal to this length over x. And that length we know is 100 minus 36, which is 64. Now we're going to cross multiply and solve for x. So we'll have x times x equal to 36 times 64. So x squared is equal to 2,304. And the square root of both sides will get x by itself, and the square root of 2,304 is 48. So our altitude, that missing length, is 48. And again, let's look at this one more time while we can set our proportions up this way. So here you can see I've redrawn my pink triangle and my blue triangle, which I've indicated. The pink triangle is the larger one formed when we draw the altitude. Now in the pink triangle, our altitude is this shorter side. And in the blue triangle, our altitude is the longer side. And the side lengths we can figure out are this green side length, which is also here. So hopefully visually, you can see that that's why we'll have x over some number as one proportion and then x over some number as another proportion. So this altitude is the longer leg in the smaller triangle, but it's the shorter leg in our larger triangle. Moving on to number two. Now note that for the large triangle, 25 is our hypotenuse. And we have this side, the smaller side, x as our unknown. So we'll write the hypotenuse 25 over x. That's going to be similar to this smaller triangle and the lengths that represent the hypotenuse and the smaller side in it. However, in that smaller triangle, our hypotenuse is x and our shorter side is that value of 9. So now we're cross multiply and solve for x. So we'll have x times x equal to 25 times 9. That's x squared equal to 225. And when we take the square root of both sides, we'll get that x is equal to 15. So 15 is our missing length in number two. In number three, we're missing the length of our altitude. The altitude x over this side 9 is proportional to this side, which is 25 minus 9. Which is 16, over our altitude x. Since in the smaller triangle formed, x, the altitude is the larger side length, and 9 is the shorter leg, and in the larger triangle formed, 16 is the longer leg, and x is the shorter leg. So now we'll cross multiply. X times x is going to be equal to 9 times 16. X times x is x squared, and that's going to be equal to 144. And taking the square root of both sides, we'll get that x is equal to 12. So 12 is our missing length in number 3. Looking at one of the smaller triangles, we're given the hypotenuse of x and this side 45. So we'll have x over 45, and since x is the hypotenuse of the similar triangle, which we'll use the largest triangle, is 81. So 81 will go in the numerator since that's where I put the values for the hypotenuse, and these are proportional. Also note that for 45, the side in the larger triangle that corresponds with the side of 45 is x. So we'll have the hypotenuse x over 45 equal to the hypotenuse of 81 over the side x. But x holds the same value for each. So x times x will equal 45 times 81. So we'll have x squared, and that will be equivalent to 3,645. And the square root of that will give us a decimal. So we're going to need to simplify. We'll take the square root of both sides to get that x is equal to the square root of 3,645. We need this in simplest radical form. So what's the largest square root that is a multiple of 3,645? And that is 27. So x is equal to the square root of 27 squared times 5. And 27 squared is 729. So 729 times 5 will give us 3,645. So splitting up this square root, we can say that x is equal to the square root of 27 squared, which is 27 times the square root of 5. So in simplest radical form, 27 square root of 5 is our missing side length in number 4. On number 5, we're missing the altitude. So x over 9 is proportional to 7 over x. So it's a longer side, the shorter side of this triangle. That's going to be proportional to the shorter side and longer side of this triangle. Cross multiplying, x times x is going to equal 9 times 7. So that's x squared, and I'm going to leave this as 9 times 7 because look, 9 is a perfect square. So when I take the square root of both those sides, I'll have that x is equal to 3 times the square root of 7. So 3 times the square root of 7 is the missing side length in number 5, which is approximately 7.94. And now, on to number 6. Our altitude is our missing length. So x over 16, the longer leg over the shorter leg of this triangle, is going to be proportional to the longer leg, 84, over the shorter leg of x. Cross multiplying, x times x equals 16 times 84. So that's x squared equal, and I'll leave this as 16 times 84. When I take the square root of both sides, I'll get that x is equal to the square root of 16, which is 4, times the square root of 84. But the square root of 84 can be simplified further. I can break the square root of 84 up into the square root into 4 times 21. And since 4 is a perfect square, I can pull out the square root of 4, which is 2. So I'll get x equal to 4 times 2 times the square root of 21. So x is equal to 4 times 2, which is 8, times the square root of 21. And that is the solution in number 6. 8 times the square root of 21. And I'll stop this video here. Join me in the next video where I'll work through numbers 7 through 12. Also, if you're confused at any point, leave a comment below. Don't forget to subscribe and also like this video. Another note is if you have difficulty figuring out how to get a radical in simplest form, there are videos and tutorials that I've already posted on this. So just write in the search bar or click a link that I'll leave in the description so that you can practice simplifying radical form.